Really incredible stuff. Sky 4 with the bird's eye today. That thick, choking smoke, flames shooting through the ceiling. And now a local business is destroyed. Two firefighters are hurt, and this story does not end there.
That's because after the flames were put out, the concerns continued. Let's check in with Action News reporter Kelly Brennan tonight. Kelly, crews very concerned about contamination and what was in the air out there.
Well, because of that concern, every precaution was taken. Actually, we're going on 6 hours now after the fire, and there is still one department on scene confirming that there was no immediate threat to the public. In these situations, it's very scary because it's what you can't see and what you can't smell that is the most dangerous to firefighters and to the public. Here's a view from Sky 4. Now, this shows you just how massive the fire is along Cheswick Avenue and Freeport Road. Most people saw the flames, smelled the smoke, and heard the explosion.
I woke up with all the helicopters and I looked out, smoke pouring everywhere. So, as we were proceeding down the road here, all of a sudden we heard a big, like an explosion, a boom.
What John Leskovic heard, Kurt Hubert survived.
We heard an explosion coming from the back of the warehouse towards the drier area.
Hubert and two others tried to put out the fire themselves, but it only grew.
The top of the roof, it had caught next. And by that time, we tried with some fire extinguishers, but there was nothing we could do. By that time, we had to move back and get out of there. It was getting hot.
Hubert and his co-workers at Filter Services got out okay. Now, this is one of four businesses in the building, all of which deal with service and repair. So in the warehouse are numerous chemicals used in their line of work, and that alone became a real threat.
If that 500 gallon goes, you better be a hell of a lot farther than we are.
The warehouse was stacked with materials from the floor to the ceiling. Upon arrival, they did the best they could.
And here's what one viewer captured on his cell phone. Most bystanders were kept far away for the threat of more explosions. In all, 10 fire departments responded, and one firefighter was taken to Mercy Hospital for burns on her hands. And because of the chemicals stored here, the attention soon turned to possible air and water contamination. But Allegheny County Hazardous Materials Team and the Health Department both determined that there is no threat to this area. Now, two families in this neighborhood were evacuated, not for a specific threat, but because there were 10 fire departments on scene, all jammed into this small block, and they simply wanted to get some residents out of the way so that there weren't any safety concerns for those individuals. Now, you also heard an employee mention that the fire started in a dryer. We are still waiting for official confirmation on that from Allegheny County Fire Marshals. Reporting live tonight in Cheswick, I'm Kelly Brennan, Channel 4 Action News.